Hi, I'm Stacey Dash, former celebrity turned political commentator. Thank you. I'm here tonight to talk to you about Great Britain's departure from the European Union. And to help me demonstrate what happened on Thursday, I've invited the Kardashians to join me.
Hey, we're the European Union.
I'm Courtney, also known as Italy.
I'm Chloe, also known as France, because I dated French Montana.
And I'm Kim, and I'm playing Germany, because just like that country's foreign immigration policies, I let almost anyone in me.
Hey, yo, what's up? I'm Rob Kardashian, AKA the United Kingdom. Black China over here is Northern Ireland, which actually makes her a part of me.
Oh, that's so romantic, son.
Oh, why are you Ireland?
You ain't never heard of Black Irish?
Mom, I mean, Brussels, I don't like Black Ireland's attitude.
Listen, England's going through a phase, okay? He'll be all right. Remember, we're one big happy union. No fighting.
Baby, we ought to be out. I don't believe we need to listen to Brussels tell us what to do.
Word?
Word.
We out.
Wait just one second. If you leave, you'll no longer have the privileges of being part of the EU, including military security, credit, trade, and future residual deals with EU.
I guess we'll take our chances.
Holla.
Awkward.
Chloe. Can I get back in the EU?
How many times have I told you, Lamar, you've been deported?
I'm saying, can I?
No, get out! Get out!
Well, now what do we do?
Ouch. I have an idea. Let's tweet.
The end.
Tonight on TMI, Johnny gets investigated, Hamilton gets annoying, and MP3 gets played. And musical guest Drew the Band and special guest host Jack McGee tonight on Two Per.
Here. You're doing TMI. Mm-hmm.
Did you forget?
Well, now you can tell me exactly what TMI is.
Oh, we're a sketch comedy parody of TMZ.
Yeah, well, great. Now, doesn't look like TMZ in here to me.
Well, I didn't say we were a realistic parody of TMZ.
Or even a good one. So.
Yeah. Okay, so what do we do?
Okay, so traditionally, you would act as Harvey Levin, and we would act as the
reporters. Whoa, I don't want to be Harvey Levin. I'm still pissed at him when he blew the lid off the story that I was tapping Keisha.
Okay, well, no, that's okay. You can be you. You as the guy, as the head of TMZ, and we'll be the people that are pitching you stories.
Yeah, we'll just tell you stories from the gossip sites, and then we go into sketches about them.
That's kind of a flimsy premise.
Well, it's all we got, so.
All right. So what stories you got for me this week?
Oh, HBO canceled Vinyl, the series about the music industry in the 70s. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it turns out about as many people were watching Vinyl as were actually buying and listening to Vinyl.
Boom! That's a record joke.
Okay, if you say so.
Right. Also this week it was reported that the guy who flew a drone about 50 feet above the premiere of that Johnny Depp movie Through the Looking Glass last month, he's being investigated for ties to terrorism. Ooh.
Oh my god, that's terrible. Those poor people. They had to deal with possible terrorism and sit through that movie?
All right, Larry, where are we with the drone guy case?
We got a few agents looking into his background. So far, we got nothing.
So you're telling me this guy could have just been flying a drone just for the hell of it?
No, that's possible.
No, that's not good. We're the FBI. We gotta be hunting down bad guys and getting results.
Boys, I've been looking through the drone guy, and I gotta tell you, I got nothing.
We've been rolling snake eyes on this one, huh?
Not necessarily. Okay, I dug a little deeper and I found something that, honestly, I'm surprised the agency hasn't looked into yet.
Oh, what is it?
Well, I take it you're familiar with Johnny Depp?
The actor?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, on a hunch, I looked into his IMDb. Did you know that he was part of such films as Transcendence, The Tourist, Dark Shadows, and Mordecai?
I read People magazine.
Not to mention The Lone Ranger.
Why isn't the Bureau investigating him?
For what?
For being the most notorious bomb maker in U.S. history?
My God, she's right! That son of a bitch did the Rum Diaries.
Exactly.
He's been hiding under our noses all this time.
All right, get the rest of the team in here.
Team, get in here!
You wanted to see us, boss?
All right, everyone, listen. The Federal Bureau of Investigation is pushing its efforts to stopping the threat of terrorism. We're opening up an investigation of Johnny Depp.
Thank God, I hated the Liberty.
But what about Chocolat?
Chocolat aside, this bastard has made one bomb after another. We've got to stop him before he makes a Secret Window 2. Or another god-awful Alice movie.
Oh, my kids haven't slept in weeks since seeing Through the Looking Glass.
Let's take him down.
Yes, but how? Look, you can't just throw someone in jail for making some of the worst movies in the last two decades. If that was the case, Adam Sandler would have got the death penalty years ago. We have to handle this carefully. Hank is right. Technically, the only law he's broken is the law of common decency.
Damn it, that's true. But you know what? We've got to change these laws. We've got to spread the word throughout the United States, even if it's a stupid idea.
But how, boss? How?
Wait a moment. I have a thought.
I, Donald J. Trump, do hereby announce my intentions to build a wall around Johnny Depp. Let's make movies great again.
HBO presents a new series about music made for people over the age of 35. It's Terrence Winter's MP3.
The year was 1998. The economy was booming. The Simpsons was the best show on TV. And the Fresh Prince, Will Smith, he was all that and a bag of chips. Me? I was a senior in college, and I'm at the top of my class, but I had one thing going for me. I had the biggest collection of CDs on campus.
Brian, we need to have a serious talk.
Melissa, I've been meaning to talk to you. Here, do you think New Jack Swing should be its own category, or a subgenre of R&B? I'm recataloging my CD collection.
That's why we need to talk, Brian. I can't be with you in your massive CD collection anymore. It's no longer cool.
Not cool? What's not cool about perfect sound forever?
Where do I start? I'm tired of sharing the seat in your Geo Metro with your giant Case Logic CD binders. And I can't handle your mood swings when your CD carousel breaks. And no matter what you may think, date night does not mean a trip to Tower Records. It's not working for me anymore.
Are you dumping me? Can we talk this out?
I'm sorry, Brian. I'm into MP3s now. Also, I'm a generic female character, and I need to break up with you so that your character can go on a journey of self-discovery. Bye.
Whatever. MP3s suck. And you suck, too. I'm so alone.
I hadn't felt this low since the time I read the lyrics to Pearl Jam's Jeremy on the CD insert of 10. I took a long, soul-searching walk to go see my best friend, Maddie. Maddie was a pleasant guy who wasn't afraid to tell it like it is. You know, like Montel Williams.
Man, I love CDs, man. You know, they're real.
You can hold them. You know, you gotta look out for fingerprints, but still. But no, no, Melissa's gotta have MP3s now. Hey, man, can you stop playing GoldenEye for like 2 seconds and listen up?
Hey, man, hey. I fought the CD fight, all right? But at some point you realize you can have all the Venga Boys hits in one file on your computer instead of having to go out there and buy multiple CDs. So you gotta ask yourself, what am I fighting for?
Computers are not made for listening to music. They're made for writing papers and playing solitaire, man. Tell me. Tell me you are not on her side.
Hey, look at me, man. I am your bro, all right? I would never betray you for a generic female character like Melissa. But you gotta get with the times, bro. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna hook you up with a Napster account.
You know what? You're right. I'm gonna get with it. I'm gonna show Melissa that I'm a changing man. I'm gonna be the Mac Daddy of MP3s.
Oh. Oh, yeah, boy. What you gotta do, you gotta go over there to her dorm room and write that on the whiteboard on her door.
No way, Jose. I'm tech savvy now. Whoa. I'm gonna go over to the computer center and send her an electronic mail.
Whoop, there it is, boy!
Ladies, in case you're wondering who this song's by, the answer is Tub Thumpin' by Chumbawamba.
Whoa, you know this song?
Know it? I've got it in my MP3 collection.
Whoa.
How big is your collection?
Just say it's big enough to hold my 2 gig hard drive.
Whoa, that sounds like a lot. Can we go to your crib and chill and listen to your collection?
That sounds fly. I'm gonna get back to you with the deets.
Jiggy.
Man, bro, man. You're like a new man since you switched to MP3s. You can have any girl you want now.
That's true, that's true. But in order for this story to have emotional resonance, I have to pine for the one that got away. Excuse me while I go unbreak my heart.
Snap!
Melissa. It's been a while.
Hey, Brian. You into Savage Garden?
You're the Ariana of our generation. Hey, did you get my electronic mail?
Oh, no, sorry. I haven't had a chance to go to the computer center recently.
Well, if you had, you'd know that I'm super into MP3s now. Hey, what do you say you come over to my dorm and you can check out my dope MP3 collection on my Dell?
MP3s on a computer? How 1996.
Oh, Brian, this is my new boyfriend, Eric. He has a Diamond Rio MP3 portable player.
32 megabytes, man.
Well, I guess we better go. Ricky Lake has an exclusive interview with the Backstreet Boys, and we don't want to miss it.
Yeah, I'm taping it.
See ya.
Hey, bro. You can't let her go. He's got a portable MP3 player, man. How am I supposed to compete with that?
I don't know, man. I don't know, but you gotta do something or you're gonna feel worse than Julia Roberts in my best friend's wedding.
You're right. Hey, Melissa! Wait! Melissa, I may not have a shiny diamond reel portable MP3 player dangling in front of your eyes, but can he make a mixtape like I can?
Tape? Dude, it has shuffle.
I don't know. But what I do know is if you give me a second chance, our life can be all the love songs that I can possibly download on my MP3 player. We could even have Celine Dion's best. We could call it our own little playlist.
Oh, Brian.
And just like that, Melissa was mine again.
2 years later, she left me for a guy who bought one of those brand new iPods that hold 1,000 songs. But don't worry, I'll get her back once I figure out how to put a scuffy card on my PC.
MP3, coming to HBO for one season.
Well, some rappers have had some really bad couple of weeks recently. Let's see, TMZ recently reported bad news for Designer, Troy Ave, and Schoolboy Q.
Ted, you made those names up.
No, honestly, I got those names from the TMZ website.
So TMZ made those names up.
TMZ, make up a story. How dare you, Shayna?
Hey, Jack, you were in that movie Moneyball, right?
Yes, I was, right? Did you like it?
I never heard of it before I got the script. I'm more of a religious dramas guy.
Okay.
But I was reading about it, and it's about the Oakland A's in the early 2000s, and they changed from a bad team to champs, right?
Yeah, there's a little girl who sings with a guitar in it, too.
I read that, too. Anyway, now that the Oakland A's are in last place again, do you have anything to say about that?
Might be time for a sequel.
In 2002, Oakland Athletics general manager Bill Beam took a last place team and turned them into champions. Now, 14 years later, those same A's are mired in last place and in desperate need of some new money in their balls. Dropping the ball. Moneyball 2.
The Oakland A's are 16 games out of first place. As a general manager, what do you have to say for yourself?
Can I start with oops?
Oops? What are we going to do? There was one time when we were a proud organization. Now we're making the name of Oakland look bad. Do you know how hard you have to work to make Oakland look bad?
Look, boss, here. I got a list of players, really good players that we should trade for, okay? You know, we need really good players because the players that we have aren't really good, okay? You got it? All right? Can I show this to you? Come on. Number one.
No, of course not! If I was good at picking players, we wouldn't even be doing this sketch, would we? But I do know someone who is good at picking players. Guys, I want to introduce to you all our new director of player development, Mr. John Poloni. Hey, Johnny!
This doesn't look like the disabilities office.
What's wrong with him?
Wrong? Hey. What could be wrong?
Which one of you is my nurse?
He looks like he's lost
no,
there, Dave.
He's just an old salty baseball guy. He's what they call colorful.
Hey, kid, get off of my porch!
Okay, Dave, what are we going to do with him?
Okay, well, you may not know what to look at him, but John was an incredible scout for us back in the early 2000s, right? He helped us build some really great A's teams back then. He's back now to help us do it again.
I'm not going to pay for it!
Okay.
How's he going to help us now?
Okay, well, John has been working really hard on a list of roster moves that we should make. Johnny, the floor is yours.
Yeah. I said it. I'm not going to pay.
Right, you're not going to. No, the list, John. The list of really good roster moves we should make.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the list. Yeah.
The list.
I got it right here.
Okay, great.
Well, taking a look at this, but a team really isn't not too bad.
See? Wow, really?
No. Well, I coached a team of a bunch of blind kids. Dirty bastards. They couldn't even catch a pop fly. Now, they were bad. At least you guys can catch it.
Okay, all right, so the team is fine the way it is.
No, this team sucks. But I got a couple ideas. Here's one of them now. Listen up. I want you to trade for Coco Crisp.
But Coco Crisp is already on the team.
No kidding. I'm not talking about the outfield of Coco Crisp. I'm talking about the cereal.
So you want us to trade for a chocolatey good cereal?
Yeah, because it's part of a complete breakfast, huh? Now you guys could use it. Be more valuable than some of the guys on this team. Be lucky if you get some grape nuts. Yeah. All right, now what you do now is you take that box of cereal, you put it right out there in right field. You can't do any worse than Coco Crisp that's out there now, I'm telling you.
I told you this guy was salty, huh?
And now you also got a problem in left field. Let me ask you something. Who is the greatest left fielder that ever played the game.
Oh, it's no question. It's Babe Ruth.
Bingo!
Oh, God, John, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to tell you this, but Babe Ruth died 70 years ago.
I know he's dead. Just wait a minute, have I got a vision inside? Just wait a second, huh? Get this cleared up. My cataracts are bothering you. It's starting to piss me off, lady. Now, here's the deal. There's also another great left fielder, David Justice. Now, come on. Huh? You get what I'm thinking out here?
No.
Oh, Jesus. Justice? Ruth?
No.
Now playing left field, Supreme Court Justice! Huh? Ruth? Bader Ginsburg! And I'm told that she's a free agent.
John, Ruth Bader Ginsburg is 83 years old. She's never even touched a baseball. How do you know she can even hit?
She can get on base! Huh? I mean, at least the second. At least that's some of the other justices tell me.
Well,
listen, we rounded up with Bud, the dog, and Kevin Costner.
Hmm?
Say what you want, but Kevin Costner always comes through in the clutch. Now, you round that out, and I think we're playing baseball in October.
Well, you know, guys, I mean, it does sound unconventional, but how much worse can we do? We're 16 games back. Hey, I mean, come on.
Damn it. Kevin Costner already signed on to do a sequel of Waterworld 2. As for Air Bud, the Yankees just offered him $150 million over 8 seasons and kibble.
Damn it! Back to the drawing board.
I do have this deal that can help us get rid of our 3 priciest contracts.
Yeah. And what do we get in return?
Amy Schumer, the band Smash Mouth, and a case of 10W30 motor oil.
I'm listening.
Thank you for calling TMZ. Have you been in a Bieber-related altercation?
We need stories for TMZ's followers.
We got nothing, Harvey.
Nothing?
How can we have nothing?
It's this heat, Harvey. You know celebrities don't like to do stupid things in inclement weather.
Damn it, you're right.
You know what that means. We need to create a hip-hop artist.
Yeah.
Why don't we just dig up some dirt on a hip-hop artist already? Like, Rich Homie Quan.
Rich Homie Quan? That's Murr from accounting. We made him Rich Homie Quan the same way we made Leonard from logistics into what's his
name? ASAP Rocky.
ASAP Rocky, yes, yes. People, we need to create a hip-hop artist. You know the drill. First, we need a name. It's got to be something to do with currency, royalty, a family member, size. Let's go.
I got one. Okay, how about Skinny G?
Skinny G.
He's like Kenny G, but he's skinny.
I love that.
And less white.
I love it. Yeah. I love it.
Yes.
Love it.
Yes.
Okay, so what are we going to say happened to Skinny G today?
He was arrested.
For what?
Missing a child support payment.
No, no, he would never miss.
Come on, what are you doing?
No, that's
sorry.
Not Skinny
so,
G.
Carrying a concealed weapon.
Okay.
That's so Skinny G.
The G, of course, meaning gangster, my idea. Gangster ending in A, which is more gangster. Thank you. Ah!
I'll make a note of that.
Skinny G, he is one bad mother. Yes, he is. Okay. Now we need to get a picture. We need a picture.
Oh, hold on. Hey, Dodd, can you come down here?
Holding.
Just one sec. Harvey, you remember Doug from accounting?
Can somebody call Doug?
This is not Doug.
Yes, it is.
Hi. This is Skinny G. Oh my gosh. Look, I'm just afraid being this close to it. Look how you're so raw. He's so raw. Look, you're so raw right now.
Well, I am in the middle of a mid-year audit.
Audit? Whoa, watch your language, Skinny G. There are ladies present, or as you like to say, biatches.
I don't say biatches.
Don't smile! I'll have that loaded to the hard side, Harv.
And I just finished the copy.
Nice.
Okay, seriously, can I go back to my audit now?
Awkward. Sorry. We can't have a gun-toting gangsta working at TMI. So, good luck with your court case. Security! Okay. Security!
Bye, Doug.
Can I get at least a reference?
Good thing we got that story out.
Yes, it is, Charles. We gotta keep the presses moving.
We don't have presses, Harvey. We're a website.
Yeah, but if we had presses, they'd have to be moving. Okay, next story. What do we have? What do we have? What do we have?
Kylie and Tyga.
Ooh, are those two kids back together?
No, they're not, but they are in the friend zone.
Friend zone is not news. Next story. Let's go.
We don't have any other stories, Harv.
How can we have nothing?
Nope. It's this damn heat.
You know what that means. Don't smile! Good luck with your hip-hop career, Poppy Pesos. Security! Security!
Ladies and gentlemen, Moo the Band.
Yeah.
welcome to the John Mayer Show, the only show featuring John Mayer's unique political opinions. Here's your host, John Mayer!
Hey, I'm your host, John, and this is my show. My stupid mind's got me in trouble. I feel too much alone. Today on the John Mayer Show, we're going to be talking with someone who's been in the news quite a bit this week. Former Donald Trump campaign manager, Mr. Corey Lewandowski. That is. I want to run. So, Lou, how you do in?
What?
How you been, man?
I've had better weeks.
Oh, yeah. Me too. Nah, just kidding. They're always good.
Yeah, and maybe for you. Sorry, look, I'm just a little on edge right now. You know, being let go from the Donald Trump campaign came as a big surprise to me.
Oh, and surprises can be no bueno.
Am I right? You are correct, I agree. You know, you think you're doing a great job, and
I mean,
all of a sudden...
it could be a late night at a dark club. You're starting to get down to business with a lady named Dana. And starts moving down south when all of a sudden, oops, Dana's actually a Dan. Surprise! Huevos! And that is a no bueno.
Excuse me?
Excuse me. That is exactly what I said to Dan.
Like I was saying, you know, being let go from the Trump campaign, it came as a big surprise to me, especially with our margin of victory in the primaries. Now, our numbers did slide a bit at the polls, but not a significant enough amount.
And if you can't get it back up, you're always gonna be pushed down. You feel me? Boom.
I do not dig you.
Well, maybe if you just need to dig a little deeper to find that feeling, you know what I mean? Boom.
Seriously,
I think that this is a perfect opportunity to take a few questions from our audience.
I've said nothing yet.
Bro. You either go with that flow, or that flow makes you go. Okay.
That is not to say at all.
You.
Hey, John.
Hey.
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 Is somebody going to say any words right here?
Hey, talk is cheap, unless you pay extra.
Hey, John, I'm Tara from Laguna Niguel.
What you got for me, Laguna?
Well, this question's actually for Mr. Lewandowski.
Lewandowski?
Great. Oh.
Yeah. Okay, Mr. Lewandowski, as Donald Trump's former campaign manager, if he becomes president, do you think that he'll elect a Supreme Court judge that'll let John Mayer take me home with him?
That has nothing to do with anything that I do.
Let's just see what happens after my court is adjourned.
Oh, John.
Any other questions? You remind me a lot of Dana. Never mind. You. Yes. Mikey the Mike Man, everybody.
Hi, Mr. Lewandowski. I understand that Donald Trump wants to build a wall from Mexico.
Yes, that is his plan.
So, if he were building walls, would he consider building one around someone's dad who may have found naked photos sent to John Mayer on their iPhone?
Once again, that has nothing to do with anything.
Let's just say that my platform has always called for a complete and total ban on fathers. Hashtag vasectomies for all. Hashtag seedless grapes, y'all.
You know what, they say Donald Trump talks out of his ass, but when I was invited to be a guest on a political talk show hosted by John Mayer, I thought I was actually going to talk politics.
Whatever time of the election, my poll is always up. You dig?
No, I do not dig. Nobody digs, you shithead.
No, yikes, I thought he was just about to grab my arm. Well, looks like Corey Lou just flipped his do. Well, that's all the time we got for this week's show. Tune in next time when we discuss the Trump effect on the down ballot candidates with my special guest, Senate Majority Whip John Cornyn and Flea from the Chili Peppers. Until then, remember.
Okay, boys and girls, what's the last pitch?
Well, it's been a crazy time for that hot new musical, Hamilton. Mm-hmm. Okay, first of all, it won like 11 Tony Awards, and then they announced that like three of the main people are leaving, like Lin-Manuel Miranda, Leslie Odom Jr., and Philip Astu are all leaving on July 9th.
Yeah, and if you thought tickets were expensive, Jack, well, you're in for a surprise. Scalpers are getting prices as high as $10,000 right now.
Wow, that's a lot of Hamilton. It was bad, Jack. It was bad. I'm sorry. I'm gonna leave now.
Well, you know what else is bad? Speaking of bad, Game of Thrones, the final season ends tonight. Not the final season, but this season ends tonight.
Why is that bad, Hannah?
Well, because we're all here doing this.
Place is pretty interesting. What's with all the swords and tapestries?
Yeah, I guess I should have warned you. My family's pretty into Game of Thrones.
Oh, cool. I love that show. It's like porno Dungeons and Dragons.
Father, Lord, Father.
Daughter?
We have returned from the date.
Where art thou, daughter? Ah, come hither, dear sweet child. It hath been too long. Who is this knight?
Father, this is William of House Nelson.
Ah, House Nelson. Bannermen to the Tullys. Sworn foes of the Mad King. Stewards of Jerry's famous deli.
Yeah, I'm from Encino.
I knew it! You have the look of an Encino man. We are well met.
Father, where is my lady mother?
I am afraid your mother has been taken ill.
Black fever?
Nay. 'Tis the river shits.
Oh, not the river shits.
Aye.
That's diarrhea.
We have leached her and fed her milk of the Pepto-Bismol. May the gods of the old and new grant her solid stools by morning light.
Mother, you must not stir. You are ill.
I had to lay eyes on my daughter before the river shits took me forever into the darkness. Ah, I see you brought us a handsome suitor.
Yes, mother, this is William of House Nelson. He journeyed here from Encino.
Ah, Encino, I hear they have the finest strip malls in all the realm.
Mother, don't be a fool. I apologize for my brother's quips, William. He fancies himself a regular court jester.
Why is he on his knees?
William, don't be rude. Can you not clearly see that my brother is an imp?
William, my daughter will bear you sons, for she has been flowered.
Flowers?
She has bled.
Okay, that's good to know. Thank you.
Tell me, William, how many bastards bastards have you fathered?
I don't have any bastards.
By my 15th name day, I had already had over a dozen bastards.
I've sired more bastards than the Los Angeles Lakers. You should go whoring with Steven sometime. He knows all the best massage parlors in the valley.
I learned it all from you, Father.
Lord Wilson, I have come to take what is mine.
Oh, no, William, save me!
Sorry, who's this guy?
This is Chad Ramsey, my meter maid ex-boyfriend from County Orange.
It's true. I enjoy inflicting pain and suffering upon the innocent. Now, you will give me your daughter, I will lay siege to your condo.
You shall not have her, I bid thee to Cerritos.
No, I will take what is mine. Also, who has the steed with the license plate 6AJB615?
That's my car.
Oh, I have issued thee a ticket for parking in the zone of loading.
But it's Sunday!
Oh dear, what a pity.
Is nobody gonna do anything? You just kidnapped her.
Aye, she is but a daughter. But what a shame for the ticket man.
Yes, William, are you going to go to King's Landing and contest it?
Aye, but we must be soon parted, Sir William. For soon the season finale of Game of Thrones shall be upon us.
Yes, I wish you godspeed on your travels, William, for the 405 is dark and full of terror. It sorrows me that Lisbeth will not lie in your bed this eve.
You know, that's all right. I can always go home and help my sister, right?
So you do watch the show!
Of course! All right, everyone, thank you so much for coming here. As you all know, this is Marianne's last day before she leaves us on her extended maternity leave.
Yeah, Marianne! Okay, hey, I'm only gonna be gone 2 weeks because that's all the time I could get.
Well, everyone, I'm so glad that you're here. In fact, this is gonna be such a great party. In fact, Craig and Laura, they're gonna be coming with the party favors. They're gonna be coming with all kinds of balloons and celebratory stuff. It's gonna be great.
Wait, you put Craig and Laura in charge of the party?
Yeah, they're the office party committee.
Bob, do you realize what you've done?
What are you talking? I don't
know. Maybe I can induce labor. Does anyone have cayenne pepper? Or a creepy sex fetish with a third trimester lady?
No, it's gonna be fun. It's not gonna be that bad. I'm sure they're just gonna come here and have some nice balloons, and it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great.
How does the finance major go on and take her degree and turn it to a job with the biggest producers for ink for copiers and printers, and then decide to go and start a family?
Well, she put in a notice that she was with child. The others went wild, but maybe not Kyle. Bob gave us the money to make this party insane.
We got a cake, and on it put her name. What's her name?
Her name is Marianne Vesigian.
Actually, it's Margie.
Your name is Marianne Vesigian. But there's one thing that you haven't done. Giving birth.
All right, stop it. Stop it.
I am so glad you stopped me right there. That next verse was a real bear monster.
Whoa. Oh my God, Lin-Manuel is a genius.
No, a genius is Albert Einstein. Lin-Manuel is so much more than that.
Stop. You guys are not going to hijack another office party with your Hamilton obsession.
Oh, okay? I'm sorry. Did you say hijack? Are you in the same way that the British hijacked the colonies at Yorktown? The maternity leave party!
2016! Monsieur Johnson!
Madam Silver, man!
Did you go and buy a cake?
Yes, that was the plan!
I got party favors!
Now it's time for some fun!
Co-workers, we get the job done!
Alright, stop it! That was the best part! You caught us off! The best part, Bob! God, come on!
You know what, guys? We get it! You like Hamilton!
Bob! Like is a severe understatement, okay? For me, seeing Hamilton was a transformative event.
You didn't even see Hamilton, Laura.
That might be true, okay? But I saw the performance at the Tonys.
And don't forget about the cast album. That is a game changer. I listen to it all the time on my free Spotify account.
That and the commercials, it's a free account.
I love that Ace Hardware spot.
Ace is the place for the helpful hardware man.
I just, nothing, stop, everything, stop it.
You're right. I'm sorry, this isn't about us.
I'm sorry, guys, it's just that the story of Alexander Hamilton, for some reason, has just really inspired us.
I am so inspired!
It's like when your life, you have to find that thing that lights your fire, you just, you end up like someone like Kyle.
My fire's lit, damn you!
Look, you guys, we're really sorry that we made this all about someone who came to this country from nothing.
Yeah.
And then he just uses his crazy brain power to move his way up through the system.
Hey, Craig, Craig! Stop.
I'm sorry.
Sorry.
It's okay. Okay, can we just please
yes.
go back to Marianne's party before she goes into labor?
Yes. Fantastic idea. Come on, guys. Just celebrate. Let's
okay.
go.
Okay.
Okay. How about another song?
Yeah.
Oh, another song from Hamilton!
All right, Jesus Christ.
Oh, I like this one.
This is not a bitch folks not more than go to downtown.